Good morning, children. This week we will continue with the lesson Reproduction in Plants, which we have started last week. So in our previous session we have learnt about the reproductive parts of a flower. Do you remember what are they? Yes, they are stamen and pistil. So the stamen is divided into two parts, that is anther and the filament. Inside the anther are present the pollen grains, and the pistil is divided into three parts, that is stigma, style and ovary. Inside the ovary are present the ovules. The stamen is also called as andrecium and the pistil is called as the gynoecium. We have also learnt about the pollination. What is pollination, children? Transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma is called as pollination. And there are two types of pollination, that is self-pollination and cross-pollination. In self-pollination, the pollen grains are transferred from anther to stigma of the same flower or anther to stigma of one flower to the other flower but on the same plant. Whereas cross-pollination means transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma of one plant to the other plant. Now what happens after the pollen grains reach the stigma? And how are the fruits formed from a flower? After successful pollination, the stigma secretes nutrients, that is some sugary substance. Pollen grains absorb these and start growing in the form of a thin tube called pollen tube until it reaches the ovule inside the ovary. Then it releases male gamete into the ovule. Fertilization takes place and results in the formation of a zygote. So what is fertilization now? Fusion of male part, that is pollen grains, and female part, that is ovule, in a flower is called as fertilization. As you can see here clearly, when the pollen grain has fallen on the stigma, it produces a pollen tube. Through the pollen tube, the male gamete reaches the ovule and thus the zygote formation takes place. Now the zygote is formed. Let's see here what happens after that. After fertilization, the petals wither, means the petals start falling. Ovary begins to swell and seeds develop inside the fruit, that is fruit grows bigger and bigger. Can you see the difference here now? The flower, when it was pollinated, the ovary started growing and then finally it developed into a fruit. So now the fruit is fully grown with the seeds inside it. These seeds are used to grow new plants. So with this we can conclude that the pollination is important for a flower to develop into fruit. That's all for today, children. Thank you.